The president then introduced, I guess you could call it a campaign-style video. It had earmarks of a propaganda-style video. We're not going to show it to you because it's full of deceptive editing and taking statements out of context and is clearly designed to tout his administration's response and rewrite history of it. He followed that with more complaints about the coverage, including the Times story, again, and said if he'd acted sooner, 3 months sooner, is how he put it, quote, I would have been criticized for being way too early.
So when you look at the propaganda that the media claim, it's actually Trump using their own words.
Joining me now is Dan Gaynor. He is the vice president of the Media Research Center. Dan, thank you so much for joining me.
It's a pleasure, even if we're doing it long distance across the country.
Yes, very far across the country. I'm in Arizona, and I believe you're in Maryland right now.
Yeah, exactly.
And for those of you watching, please don't forget to like and subscribe to The Daily Caller. Now, Dan, you've been keeping a closer eye on this than I have, probably. And it's just really mind-boggling how some folks in the mainstream media are carrying water for communist China. And there's a lot of examples of this every single day. Not only that, but they're blaming President Trump for the coronavirus, which is... I don't get it. I mean, back in January, he was warning about the coronavirus and was taking steps to protect our country from getting coronavirus. So one of the examples that you had is of CNN insisting that the White House video using the media's own words is Chinese propaganda. And we have the video.
The president then introduced, I guess you could call it a campaign style video. It had earmarks of a propaganda-style video. We're not going to show it to you because it's full of deceptive editing and taking statements out of context and is clearly designed to tout his administration's response and rewrite history of it. He followed that with more complaints about the coverage, including the Times story, again, and said if he'd acted sooner, 3 months sooner, is how he put it, quote, I would have been criticized for being way too early.
So when you look at the propaganda that the media claim, it's actually Trump using their own words. And so let's do a quick timeline here. This virus started in China. It killed an estimated at least 40-some thousand people. China still claims it killed about 2,500. Our own intelligence agencies now are the ones who had to ferret out that information. China lied about how many people died, how many people got the virus, continues to lie to this day, now falsely blames the United States as the U.S. military gave it to them. Russia has chimed in, and they're also lying about it. So when Donald Trump talks about how the media are pushing propaganda, they're really pushing propaganda. When they say the United States has more dead than any other nation, first of all, they don't adjust for population. We're one of the most populous countries in the world. And next, they don't adjust for the fact that China lies every single day. And so when they put that information out there, they are carrying water for a dictatorship that locks up more than a million people that, because of their religion, treats Christians absolutely horrible, locks up Black people, says they can't even leave their homes, and constrained travel from Wuhan within China when this virus was taking place, and didn't stop travel from Wuhan to the rest of the world. So they let tens of thousands of people around the world die. And Donald Trump calling them on it, and the media say he's racist.
Well, remind me, I think some in the media were suggesting that maybe the coronavirus actually started in the U.S., which was Chinese propaganda.
Yeah, well, there's all this talk about, you know, one of the reasons why New York has it so bad, a lot of the cases came from Europe. They say, oh, see, these cases came from Europe, not from China. Well, they didn't get to Europe from Europe. They got to Europe from China. They're one of the reasons, at least it's been theorized, one of the reasons why Italy has it so bad is Italy has extraordinarily large Chinese immigrant population, both legal and illegal, because of the fashion industry. They work with China on that. So that may or may not be the cause, but the media don't dig into it because they don't want to know. They don't want to do anything that damages the relationship with China, which gets to the other point. They love using China against Trump because it makes Trump look bad in their minds. But they also don't want to offend China because they all have corporate ties to China. I mean, NBC News, their corporate parent, Universal, is building a theme park in Beijing. Do you see them reporting on that? One time.
Yeah. And also the Media Research Center pointed out a couple other examples of CNN unhinged, specifically one of our favorite reporters, White House reporters, Jim Acosta. Apparently he called President Trump Baghdad Bob. What's that all about?
Yeah. I mean, he's saying, you know, basically Trump is lying. If anybody remembers the war in Iraq, Baghdad Bob was famously the guy, the PR guy who was going out there and telling the whole world everything's going fine while American tanks are like rolling down the streets of Baghdad. And so what he's saying is Trump is sort of just flat out lying. And that's false. Flat out false. The United States has a population of about 330 million. You compare the number of dead to some of these other countries, and you know our population is something like 4.5 to 5 times that of Italy. You know, I mean, it's they don't want to put statistics in context. They simply want to bash people, and nobody wants to bash people more than CNN. CNN is just an arm of the left. It no longer functions as anything like a media outlet. The chyrons they ran this week from the Trump presser all were just saying Trump pushing propaganda, Trump saying this thing and this thing. That's not what a news organization does. They're not one. They stopped being one. They haven't been one in years, but now under Jeff Zucker's reign, their whole goal is simply to fix the presidential election.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to watch these press briefings, not because of President Trump and the coronavirus task force and all of his officials and experts that he's bringing in to inform our country, but it's the White House reporters that they're allowing in that are coming in there to look for a fight and get attention rather than ask serious questions. Now, of course, there are some good reporters in there asking important questions, but you get the vibe that they just want to go in there and battle it out with President Trump.
Yeah, it's like 2 hours of gladiatorial combat every day. And I mean, that's rough watching Paula Reed from CBS go there and call out the president. That's not their job. Their job is to ask questions, to report, not to argue and propagandize. So yesterday, or it's all sort of a blur, yesterday I think it was that Trump was getting in the fight with Brian Karam from CNN. You had Yamiche Alcindor complaining that the Surgeon General, she's African-American, he's African-American. She was complaining about the words he used, trying to speak to the communities of color. Instead of worrying about the lives of the communities of color, she was worried about the PC victim, terms that we can use.
Yeah, unbelievable. And then here's another one that hasn't really gotten a lot of attention, but I did read it. You can probably better explain it, but Bloomberg News shut down an investigation into the Chinese Communist Party elites, and they ended up even firing a reporter. Where's the outrage?
Oh, there it's, and I'll give NPR credit. This is an NPR story. We wrote about it. But what it shows, this Bloomberg News is supposed to be this reputable, massive global news enterprise. And a lot of things came out during Bloomberg's campaign, how he wouldn't let them write negative things about him or Democrats. And people said, even Washington Post said that was icky. And now we find out that they simply didn't want to make China's leadership look bad as a way of staying in the market in China. And remember, right as all this was happening, China kicked out journalists from China because they were making the government look bad. So this is how they play this game. And that a news organization run by a guy who ran for president is so corrupt that it's basically kowtowing to a nation that lied to us and cost tens of thousands of lives in America. I don't think I've ever seen anything this horrible.
Yeah, and I remember Michael Bloomberg, when asked, he wouldn't criticize communist China.
Yeah, I mean, it's standard practice. None of them want to criticize China because it's simply a numbers game. China's got 1.3 billion people. And they all want access to that market. And they know China uses its soft power. It's the power, if you don't do exactly what we want, we'll cut you off. remember when the NBA was having issues with China and you see LeBron James, King James himself, going out there putting forth communist China propaganda rather than defending the people who wanted freedom in Hong Kong because he was simply prostituting himself.
Yeah, it was truly sickening. And now I want to jump over to New York Governor Andrew Cuomo. He's become somewhat of a darling of the left. We've even heard people suggest that he should run for president. And he's been doing the press conferences, which I think is important. New York has been hit really hard by the coronavirus. And he has a big state and a large population that he needs to talk to. So that's important. I would say that sometimes he's a little bit inappropriate when it comes to criticizing the president. He says he doesn't want to make it political, but clearly he takes political jabs where he can.
Well, this is such a bizarre circumstance because here he is, he's going on CNN where his brother works and going on a show with his brother, and CNN is putting that forth like it's journalism. They run these daily pressers from him and the media are all agog. Oh my gosh, this is great. And then they complain about the Trump pressers when they complain when they didn't get Trump pressers. And they've built up Cuomo like he's the basically Biden's relief pitcher. If you think that Biden doesn't look like he's be able to finish the race, well, then the Democratic Party will put up Cuomo. And the media have built him up. And it's shocking because he's the governor of the state that's been hit the worst. It's got the worst death total. And you would think the media, who want to blame Trump for every person who's gotten sick in the U.S., would do the same for Andrew Cuomo. And no, instead, they want to rationalize everything going on in New York.
Yeah, and you brought up the press conferences, which we kind of talked about. But yeah, there are networks and primetime hosts who have been talking about not even airing these coronavirus press briefings when it's really relevant information for all the people that are at home right now.
Yeah, this is the major media. They get upset because Trump's popularity has gone up because of the press conferences. People see him out there fighting the battle every day. And so the Washington Post and people at CNN and elsewhere are all saying, oh, well, we shouldn't broadcast these. And you know why they don't want to broadcast these is because they are trying to see Donald Trump lose. That's not the role of media. You know, speaking for conservative media, I just want to see a neutral battleground. I don't want to see suddenly ABC, CBS, NBC, CNN, et cetera, decide that they want to get a Republican elected any more than a Democrat. My belief is that conservative principles will win out in any sort of battle for anything if they get a fair battleground. And the media don't want to give them one.
Yeah, I think you're right on that. Well, Dan, we're going to have to leave it here. Thank you so much for your insight and everything you guys do at the Media Research Center.
Thank you very much. Always a pleasure.